Hello and namaste to everyone. So in my last video of trigonometry, we have discussed I think question number 8 of exercise 8.1, chapter 8, NCERT CBSE class 10 textbook. Today I am going to start with question number 9 of exercise 8.1 on page 181. So let's start. 8.1, page 181. In triangle ABC, right angle at B, if tan A is equals to 1 by root 3, find the value of. So let's see what is given into the question. They are asking us to find the value of sin A cos C plus cos A sin C, and second is cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. First, let's draw the triangle. This is a triangle which is given in the question, right angled at B. So ABC. Now tan A is equal to 1 upon root 3, right? Tan A is equal to what? 1 upon root 3. And tan A is equal to side opposite to angle A upon side adjacent to angle A, right? This is what tan A is equals to, side opposite to angle A and side adjacent to angle A. This is 1 upon root 3. Now let us suppose there is some number k which is deducted from both numerator, which is cancelled from both numerator and denominator, right? So using the same analogy which we have used in our previous question, can I say side opposite to angle A is what? K. So this is angle A, side opposite to angle A becomes K, and side adjacent to angle A becomes what? Root of 3K. Can I say this? That side opposite to angle A is K, and side adjacent to angle A is root 3 of K. Can I say this? Okay. Now, let us use Pythagoras theorem here, because we need to find out the value of sin A, cos C, cos A and sin C. So let us use Pythagoras theorem. Can I say AB square plus BC square is equals to AC square, right? What is AB square? Root 3K whole square plus BC is K whole square. That is going to be equal to AC square. Root 3 into root 3 becomes 3. K into K becomes K square. Plus K square is equals to AC square. That is 4K square is equals to AC square. That gives AC as 2k, right, taking square root on both the sides, that gives me AC as 2k. Can I find the value of sin A? If I know all the values of this given triangle, I can easily find the value of sin A. Sin A will be what? Side opposite to angle A upon hypotenuse. Which side is opposite to angle A? K. And hypotenuse is what? 2K. Right? In the similar manner, can I say sin C, that K and K cut, that gives me sin A is half. Sin C is equals to side opposite to angle C upon hypotenuse. Which side is opposite to angle C? See, this is angle C. The side opposite to angle C is root 3K. So root 3k upon 2k, kk cancel again. So can I write here sin A is equals to half and sin C is equals to root 3 by 2, right? In similar manner, let us find cos A and cos C, because these are the values which we need to find the solution of the question which it is asking, right? Now cos A is side adjacent to angle A upon hypotenuse. Which side is adjacent to angle A? Chal, this is the side adjacent to angle A. That is root 3k. Upon hypotenuse is what? 2k. K and K cancel. So, cos A is equal to what? Root 3 by 2. Now, cos C. Side adjacent to angle C upon hypotenuse. Which side is adjacent to angle C? This is C. This is adjacent to angle C, that is K. Hypotenuse is 2K. K and K cancel. That gives me cos C is what? Half. Right? So let's write the value of cos C there. Where we have written all the values. Now see, what the question is asking you to find. First thing it is asking you to find is sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. Now what we have to do? We just have to substitute the values here. What is sin A equals to? Half. What is cos C equals to? Root 3 by 2. What will be added now? Plus, cos A is what? Root 3 by 2. And sin C is what? Sorry, cos. I think I have done some mistake here. I have to write sin A and cos C. So, sin A is half and cos C is also half. I have written by mistake, I have written root 3 by 2 here. So, let me correct this. Sin A is half and cos C is also equals to half. Right? And now, cos A is equals to what? Root 3 by 2 into sin C is also equals to root 3 by 2. Right? I have just kept the values here. In triangle P PQR, right angle at Q. PR plus QR is equals to 25 cm and PQ is equals to 5 cm. Determine the values of sin P, cos P and tan P. See, there is a triangle PQR. Let's first draw a triangle PQR and this is right angle at Q. Right angle at Q. PR plus QR is equals to 25. So this plus this is equals to 25 and PQ is given to us as what? 5. So let me write PQ here. That's 5 cm. And this plus this is equals to 25 cm. And I need the values of sin P, cos P and tan P. Once I have values for all the sides, then I can easily take out the value of sin P, cos P and tan P. So see what? PR plus QR is equals to 25. Right? Let us suppose that QR is equals to x centimeter. Right? If QR is equals to x centimeter, then PR plus x is equals to 25. Can I say PR is equals to 25 minus x? Right? So, PR is equals to 25 minus x. Now, how are we going to solve this? Again using Pythagoras theorem, I can say PQ square plus QR square is equals to PR square. Right? Using Pythagoras theorem, I can say perpendicular square plus base square is equals to hypotenuse square. PQ is equals to what? 5 whole square. QR is equals to x whole square. And PR is equals to 25 minus x the whole square. I hope you all know this identity. A minus B whole square is equals to A square plus B square minus 2AB. If you don't know, then you should learn this identity as this is very important identity from examination point of view. So, I will expand 25 minus x whole square using this identity. I will have 5 square as 25. X whole square as x square. Then 25 ka whole square is equals to 625. Then again x ka whole square. Then minus 2ab, yani minus 2 into 25 into x, right? That gives me as minus 50x. I can cancel x square and x square, right? Okay, now that gives me 25 is equals to 625 minus 50x. If I take 25 here and 50 here, okay, I am changing the position of 25 and minus 50x. So minus 50x will come here will become plus 50x. Plus 25 when goes here becomes minus 25. That gives me 50x is equals to 625 minus 25. 50x is equals to 600. That gives me x as nothing but 12 centimeter. X is equals to 12 centimeter. If x is equals to 12 centimeter, that is QR is equals to 12 centimeter. Then PR is equals to 25 minus x. That is 25 minus 12. That is equals to 13. So PR is equals to what? 13 centimeter. So let's write these values here. X is 12 and PR is equals to 25 minus 12. That gives me 13 centimeter. Now what will be sin P equals to? Side opposite to angle P upon hypotenuse. Which side is opposite to angle P? You can clearly see 12 cm. That is QR is opposite. Right? QR is opposite to angle P and hypotenuse is PR. That is 13 cm. So sin P is equals to what? 12 upon 13. Cos P will be equals to side adjacent adjacent to angle P upon hypotenuse. Which side is adjacent to angle P? Side adjacent to angle P is 5 cm, that is PQ. 5 cm upon hypotenuse is 13 cm. So that gives me 5 by 13 as cos P. Cos P is 5 by 13. Now, what tan P will be equals to? Please mention it in comment section. Enjoy learning. Thank you.